Here's the campsite that we were looking at yesterday, but it's too high up and there's almost nowhere to put in. And it, if you fall in, it's very deep water. So we chose not to stay on it. And apparently the washroom is up even higher than that is. But it's beautiful.
Oh, it's
growling. The portage is up in the narrows to the left. Is a little overgrown and we had to stop to find how to go through because it was not very clear. So, but we have found the trail again and Brent's marked it. Take a toll on these trails because they're not heavily used. So it's much better now, and we'll show you another way we know are these blazes, old blazes on the trees. We're coming and going. It's the end of the portage. Nobody's really been here in a while. Maybe in the past, like very few people go through here. And there's a beautiful cliff. miniature huts. Pardon me. Well, they get their victim and go down. All right, let's go. This is Nichol Lake. We just came through the narrows. Nichol. Nichol Lake. And we don't think too many people come here, but it's beautiful. And it's still part of the conservation area. Over there. I'm going past this rock, and the portage is in here somewhere.
Well, not the middle, actually. We're maybe 100 meters into the portage, into Isbister, and right uphill. So I don't know if you can see that. We've pretty much been uphill the whole time, so we just stopped for a break. These two portages we've done are pretty basic. You gotta keep your eyes right in front of you the whole way, and every time there's a blowdown, you have to stop and look around to try to find it. But there are blazes on the trees, not many ribbons, but like that is an old blaze on this side. And that's about how old these blazes are that you're looking for on this portage. There's another one on that side. You're looking for, and we've seen them regularly all the way along. Every time we get kind of misplaced, we look around and we do see them on the trail. So, well, hunters, trappers, whoever put them in, old explorers, who knows. So beautiful little forest. Good news is we're going up high, so maybe we're avoiding the swamp on this one. And we're back at it. Stop to go over a big tree and then locate the trail. But if you look at that great big white pine there, there's a blaze just knocked into that tree. You can imagine how long ago that must have been put in there. And then we had to stop here, and we're heading into this, and believe it or not, there is a trail in there. So I've gone up ahead and marked a few ribbons where some of the notches are, just so we can find our way, and we're back at it. Took another little breather here at the top of a great big hill. A couple of really nice big old trees, one on that side. Say hi, Al. And one in there. It's just a humongous old tree. Just a great big old dinosaur. And there's a great big old birch there with a blaze on it. So we're carrying on. By a huge white pine at the top of this hill that had fallen down. And then we just came across a nice tab. So I can't look through the trees here and really see the height of it, but that's a be one of the bigger ones I've ever seen. Yeah.
Later, we finished the portage, and it was tough. It was not as long as the other one, but there we are. And there's Brent.
There I am. 20 pounds lighter.
I'm ready for a swim.
So this is our camp here at Isbister. We took the first one off to the portage. Let's see from here, it's just a gorgeous view. Lake's long and narrow, kind of a channel, really high on each side. So we're set up over there. Gonna make some dinner. We'll go out and do some fishing. Apparently this lake only has lake trout in it. With the temperatures, I'm not sure that we'll get any, but this should be a nice paddle anyway. It's an exceptionally beautiful place here. It's just... And again, it doesn't look like anyone's been here for quite a while. We had to tidy things up a bit. A couple of blueberries down there. Yeah, we're up really high here. Everything's set up. The laundry out drying. That's it. And we got a nice little fire going over here. It's beautiful right down there. You can see it's bright. So, all in all, it's been a pretty good day. We're tired, so we're trying to sleep. Yeah, I guess we started out today on sugar. We were woken up at like 5 o'clock by something splashing around the water down by the tent. So not really sure. Sounded like a bear, but in reality it could have just been an otter. We just passed a couple of otters on the way out and I thought, that's probably what it was. So anyway, that woke us up. And then in the middle of the night, I heard something go running past the tent down the trail from the washroom, and we saw some tracks, but they were small, so we don't know if it was
a lynx
or a marten or fish or anything like that. So that was kind of weird. And then on the way back, it brushed the tent. It kind of ran down. And a little while later, it ran back and it brushed my. That was kind of strange. And then, besides that, it was uneventful. Packed up, had a nice paddle out of Sugar Lake, and nice little what was it, 400 into that one lake.
Yeah.
What was that lake called?
Nichols.
That was not bad. Not bad for fun. Really had to search for the places and the trail. And nice little lake, that Nichol lake too, just back in there by itself. And then we began the big one, and it took us 2 hours, which is...
It was a 1440.
Yeah, which is a lot, you know, like we don't normally take that long, but these portages are something else in Temagami, so it's, you got to do what you got to do to get through them, and... We did eventually, and we've been just hanging out at the camp here ever since. We bought 2 brand new air mattresses for this trip that were MS. No, they're
We got some NEC. They're vectors, small, light. We're really excited to get them because they saved us some room in our pack. And we generally do single portages, so we're trying to cut back. And it was nice. So we had a hole in one of them. So today we found the hole and we put a patch, glued it, see if it holds tonight. I hope so, because we still got eight nights left after this, so it's nice to have it working. And then we just hung out some clothes to dry and went for a little paddle down the lake and
found the portage for tomorrow, the first one.
Yeah.
That goes straight up again. And then there's, I think, three more after that, because we're headed over to Barter Lake. So I guess that wraps it up for tonight.
Yeah, just going to sit here, play some dominoes, finish our game.
And let you know tomorrow's adventure.
To go to bed early.